Hey guys, Kasus here. Today I'm going to show you my fastest Stockade run and which buffs and gear I used in this run. First we begin with Brilliant Wizard Oil. Increases our spell damage by 36 and increases spell crit chance by 1%, so very awesome to have. The next one is Grilled Squid. Increases our agility by 10, which basically means more dodge chance and more crit chance. Again for Elixir of Agility, increases agility by 15, so again another boost. Swiftness of Sansa increases movement speed by 20%. For this kind of run, it's very highly recommended. Spirit of Sansala, mainly for the stat, by 15% increase, very awesome to have. Dragon Slayer buff, more spell crit, more melee crit, and 140 attack power, enough said. Blessing of Sanctuary, reducing damage deal from all sources by up to 24, must have for mass pulls. Next one is Swiftness Potion. I used two of them, one in the beginning, and when the cooldown was off I was using another one. Dragon Breath Chili scales with spell damage. Meanwhile we are running in spell damage gear, I highly recommend it to use it. Oil of Immolation does 50 fire damage to all enemies within 5 yards, a great AoE boost, and I'll take it. The last one is Goblin Sabercharge. I use it in the kill phase. It's a little bit expensive, but in this run I wanted to try it and it does a lot of damage. Here you can see the gear I used in this run. I recommend 5 pieces of the Judgment set for the bonus. It will increase damage and healing done by magical spells and effects by up to 47. And I will go into detail with a few items which are very important and very necessary for this pull. The first must-have item is Demon Forge Breastplate. It has a 3% chance of stealing 120 life over 4 seconds. The good thing about it is it does scale with spell damage. It's about 40% and 10% every second. As you can see in the video later, it usually heals about 40 per second and in the run it does 65. The next one is Skull Flame Shield. It has a 3% chance of stealing life from your enemy. It scales 100% with spell damage. This means the more spell damage you have, the more healing you will get. For movement speed, I use Goblin Rocket Boots. They gave me 70% movement speed for 20 seconds, but they can break. My first trinket was Shard of the Fallen Star. It does a lot of AoE damage. Some people will wonder why the trinket. However, many mobs have hardly any life left due to Retribution Aura, Oil of Immolation or Blessing of Sanctuary, and with the trinket the mobs can be killed faster in such a run. My second trinket is Essence of the Pure Flame, which deals 13 fire damage when the attacker hits. Together with the Retribution Aura, this does a lot of damage and harmonizes very well. Enough of the talking, let's jump into the run. As you can see, I popped my first Swiftnet potion, charged the mob, running on the right side using Consecration to get all the aggro from the right one. Here the main thing is always charge Wisdom and let Wisdom up to get some mana back. Here you saw I got almost healed by 400 by my Skullflame shield, and I'm always trying to face them so I'm able to dodge, to block, and don't get stunned by them. That's the only issue here. I tried it 2 or 3 times. I got stunned twice on the right side. On the left side it's okay. You can see here I charged them all to get them. But on the right side they're usually stunned, and in this run I was lucky not to get a stun. So it saved some time. As you can see now here it's healing. The chest plate is healing me by 65. So a very good healing. And I'm almost 100% life at the current time. And I'm already pulled 50% of the dungeon. The only issue is here to get some mana back, so that's why I always have Seal of Wisdom up. Charging this one perfectly, and now again the chest procced again, and you can see I do not lose any health by now. Now I'm moving to the last room of the left side of the dungeon, pulling this one, and now you can see I got some poison, I cleanse it and use my rocket boots. So I get some distance to them and it works perfectly. In this run they didn't break, so I got the full 20 seconds use of it and it was perfect. Now here it's a little bit tricky. Usually as said before they're stunned, but I was lucky not to get stunned. I didn't use a fat potion, so no worry about this one. As you can see here, the green light, my chest was healing again. So it procs all the time, especially when you have aggro from every mob. Now I use my second swiftness potion, pulling the last three rooms. As you can see, I charge them again. Now you see, that didn't stun me. That was the crucial part of it. Put some consecration up. And at this point, my kill phase begins here right now. I'm using Oil of Immolation, put consecration down and use my trinket. I'm currently stunned, but the damage is really, really good. And as you can see, I use my charge as well and almost everything is dead. Now I'm running outside, kill some mobs, switching from Skullflame shield to my engineering shield. And I'm trying to kill everything using my consecration again. And now you can see I cleared it in 2 minutes and 40 seconds. If you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up. And if you want to see a specific dungeon, please write it in the comments below. See you in the next video.